Ethics. It is a fundamental part of the world in which we operate. It is a framework in which we decide what is morally right and wrong. Without realization, it shapes every single one of our decisions we make in an attempt to make a positive impact. Ethics is found in a variety of different fields within society, whether it be business, history, sociology, as well as many other fields. However, the importance of ethics is unparalleled within medicine. Medicine is built on the structure of ethics and the idea that it creates a trust between the patient and the doctor. It allows doctors to have a strong sense of certainty what to do in certain situations, whether it be to do with confidentiality, justice, or autonomy. However, it can potentially lead to complications. There are many conflicts between ethics in terms of the ethical medical pillars, and as well in society as a whole. The idea of what to do in what is right and wrong is not always as clear as we hope. There are many ongoing ethical debates that are currently going on within the world, such as euthanasia, abortions, as well as many others. One that I find extremely interesting is the idea of stem cells, which I'll be discussing today, and how ethics shapes the boundaries in which we are able to utilize these unique type of cells. Now, you might be wondering, what exactly are stem cells? Well, they are undifferentiated cells that are able to specialize to serve a specific function. These can be from muscle cells to white blood cells. The place in which these stem cells are extracted from can influence what purpose they serve. The most interesting type of stem cell is the embryonic stem cell. Due to its pluripotent properties, it is able to become any type of cell within our body. This means that in an ideal world, it has the ability to differentiate and could potentially revolutionize the field of medicine. It could potentially lead to uncurable diseases being able to be treated and gives hope to people who suffer from these diseases. Now, I'm sure you're wondering, if these stem cells are able to treat so many diseases, why aren't we using them? The fact that these cells are able to become whatever they potentially want to be is the problem itself, due to the fact that we want it to become one singular cell, and the chances of this happening are very slim and very hard to do. There are many risks as well to do with this in terms of development of tumors. It also links back to the point of ethics. Ethics is the reason why this topic is not as black and white as we perceive. There is no definite answer if stem cells should be used, and I'm sure is a debate that will continue for many years. There are currently some attempts in order to use stem cells in the modern world today, such as treatments for leukemia. But there are conflicting views on how they should be utilized, as both perspectives want to protect life. From one perspective, the research developed utilizing stem cells could potentially save many lives due to cell replacement. However, due to the extraction of these stem cells being from early stage embryonic stem cells, this could potentially raise a concern of this being potential life. This leads to the issue on whether we prioritize many lives who fall victim to some diseases or to save potential lives. Even if there were not necessarily ethical boundaries put in place, we are unsure of whether these research is possible or would it cause more damage and potential side effects. To what extent do we prioritize potential developments within science that could save millions of lives and cause a paradigm shift, but at the risk of being unethical? The ethical boundaries put in place have obviously been carefully thought out by organizations such as the FDA within the United States. These boundaries were put in due to situations such as Henrietta Lacks. Henrietta Lacks was an African-American woman who had cervical cancer in 1951. She had some of her sample tissues taken and were used for other research without her consent or awareness. This led to the research of HeLa cells. These cells have cell-like characteristics and have been used for cancer research, AIDS, and even the COVID-19 vaccines. Her genome sequence was also made public in 2013, and leaking this important information led to further concerns of informed consent. There have been more than 11,000 research publications using her cells, and the fact that Henrietta Lacks' family did not get any financial rewards or benefits causes further ethical considerations. This also highlights a problem within the scientific field that individuals who have given such significant contributions do not get the recognition that they deserve. Henrietta Lacks' story demonstrates the idea that is it truly worth disregarding ethical considerations within the medical field in order to create life-changing developments? Ethical considerations have obviously been very critical in stem cell use in order to prevent negative misuse in terms of potential cloning. But should these ethical boundaries be so heavily restricted and prevent potential vital treatments of diseases such as cancer that could cure millions of individuals. There will never necessarily be a right or wrong answer, but we are currently sitting on endless possibilities with the use of stem cells that we may not necessarily be able to see. Thank you.